In today's A-level and IB chemistry video, we're going to be looking at the ideal gas equation, and this is an equation which you must know off by heart, which is PV equals nRT. It's not difficult to use, but it is important that every single term is in the correct unit. So let's first of all work out what PV nRT stands for. So P stands for pressure, and this must be in pascals. V stands for volume, which must be in meters cubed. N is for number of moles, so it doesn't have a unit. R is the gas constant, which you must remember the value of, which is 8.31. And lastly, T stands for temperature, which must be in Kelvin. And now we're going to look at a couple of examples so that you can actually see how you would correctly use this equation. So in this first question, we're being asked to calculate the volume in meters cubed of a balloon filled with 0.4 moles of hydrogen gas at a temperature of 22.9 degrees Celsius and a pressure of 1.20 pascals. So let's start by writing out the ideal gas equation, PV equals nRT, and now we're going to list each of those values and make sure they're in the right unit. So P stands for pressure, and it's 1.20 pascals, which is great. That's the unit we want. Volume we're after, so we're going to call that X. N is the number of moles, given as 0.400, perfect. R is the gas constant, which you need to know off by heart, which is 8.31. And then lastly, we've been given the temperature as being 22.9 degrees Celsius, but remember we need that in Kelvin. The way in which you convert a degree Celsius to Kelvin is by adding 273 to it. So let's just quickly do that now, and you get 295.9 Kelvin. So we're ready to go. We can just substitute in all of our values. So I like to just keep rewriting what it is I'm doing so I don't get confused. Pressure is 1.20. Volume we're after. N is 0.4. R is 8.31. T is now 295.9. So let's sort it out. So 1.2x equals, multiply these three numbers together on the right hand side to get 983.5716. How do you get x by itself? Well, you need to divide both sides by 1.2, and x equals 820 meters cubed to three significant figures. In our second example, we're being asked to calculate the number of moles of 1.5 decimeters cubed of oxygen at 75 degrees Celsius and 250 kilopascals. So here's our equation, PV equals nRT, listing all the values, so PV, N, R, and T. Pressure we know is 250 kPa. We need to multiply that by 1000 to make sure it's in the correct unit, which is pascals. Looking at our volume now, so we have been given decimeters cubed, 1.5 decimeters cubed. Remember, we need that in meters cubed. So how do you convert decimeters cubed to meters cubed? Well, you want to divide by 1000. So let's do that directly now. So 1.5 times 10 to the minus 3, or you could simply divide by 1000 straight away. Number of moles is what we're after, so I'm putting X there. R is the gas constant, so that's 8.31. And lastly, temperature, well, we've been given that in degrees Celsius, so remember we need to convert that to Kelvin by adding 273 to the value, and you get a value which is 348 Kelvin. So now we're ready to substitute into our equation. So our pressure is 250,000 times our volume, which is 1.45 times 10 to the minus 3. Equals the number of moles, which is what we're after, times the gas constant 8.31 times our temperature in Kelvin. So let's sort it out. So sort out the left hand side first of all. So 250,000 times 1.45 times 10 to the minus 3, and you get 362.5. Sort out the right hand side, 8.31 times 348, which gives us 2891.88x. To get x by itself, you want to divide both sides by 2891.88, and x, and therefore your number of moles calculated, is 0.125 moles. And that is your final answer.